going to look at slime. Who likes slime? Yeah, you know what? I'm going to need a lot more shouting out and less hands putting up. Okay, you know the rules about putting your hands up?
Yes.
Right, who likes slime?
Yes!
Right, and we are going to look at what slime is and what some uses of it are. We're going to do some chemistry to explore the properties of slime and some physics and a bit of biology as well. And to help me out today, we have got two Slime-entists. Who knows what a Slime-entist is? Really? I just made that word up, so I can't believe you quite know. Well, a Slime-entist, anyway, is a scientist who works on slime. And we have got two of the best for you here today. So, can you please give a big round of applause for Kate, the girl who puts the ooh into goo. We have Katie Norman!
My favourite kind of slime, like slugs and snails and snot. I think that's my favourite kind of slime.
Now, unfortunately, Katie has a bit of a cold today, so she's lost her voice. So don't worry if she doesn't say much. But Katie, your favourite slime? Snot? Yeah, snot. Okay, as well, yeah. Is that about your favourite slimes?
Yeah.
Yes, not good. Yeah. Right, but first off, we have to think about what slime is. Right, well, slime, first off, the basis of most slimes are molecules called polymers. Anybody heard of a polymer before? Ooh, one or two of them. So what's a polymer? Well, a polymer are basically really, 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 really long molecules. Okay? Hugely long molecules that are made up of lots of little molecules all joined together. Okay, so for example,
around a bit, what happens?
move around a bit, keep them in the parachute. But stop! They don't mix, they don't stick to each other, do they? They're just like a liquid, that's like a liquid, molecules of a liquid, bubbling around the bottom of the ball. But if we had these balls have got Velcro on them. Some of them have got hooks on, some have got, and Phil's got a bucket there of the other side, the fluffy side. So if you put Phil, go on then, chuck yours in. Okay, and I'll chuck a few of these in. Right, now mix them around. Okay, not too much. Keep them in there. Stop.
Right, what have we got?
Now we're starting to get the more things sticking together. Ooh. Yep. And they stick together to form these long chains. And that's just like what polymers was happening with polymers. Lots of small molecules sticking together to make longer ones. Let's put a few more hooks in and see what happens. Look. Go on then. Mix. Lots of them. Yeah, they're good. Mix and a bit more, a bit longer. And the longer we leave it, the longer it starts to react. And stop. And now we've got some really big long molecules. Yeah? All stuck together. And that's exactly what's going on with polymerization, when we make polymers like cellulose or plastics and everything, are all examples of polymers. Right, thank you very much. Round of applause for our students here. And we're going to take that down.
Wonderful.
Right, so that's sort of explaining a bit about what a polymer is, but we haven't seen any real ones yet. So, well, we haven't seen any real good demos of it yet. So, here's a challenge for you guys. I want one of you to make me a polymer, a real polymer, quickly. That's rude, Phil. Katie, go on then, see what you can do.
Right. What's she got on her? What's she getting?
She's getting some kit. Oh, this is interesting. We've got this stuff, it's called sodium silicate.
Okay.
What's it look like? Can I pour some in there? Yeah? So it looks like. And you'll see that is. Oh, is that enough? Thank you. It looks like a sort of thick liquid, doesn't it? Thick, clear liquid. So you'll see that? Yeah, we have the rest, are you, Phil?
Yep.
And then what else have you got here? Hand gel. Well, our hands are dirty.
Okay. Alright, I didn't quite get this, but anyway, carry on.
It goes in there, and we see. And then you mix it around. Right. It's turning to a sort of goo. Do you need a bit more? Is that alright?
Oh yeah.
It's turned from a liquid into a sort of thick goo. Can I grab a bit out?
Ooh, look at
that. It's sort of slimy and gooey. And so I think what's happened there is we've taken the hand gel and actually the ethanol, the alcohol in the hand gel, and it's reacted with the sodium silicate and stuck all the sodium silicate molecules together. So this stuff is like the balls in our parachute, and ethanol, alcohol, is like the Velcro in our parachute, yeah? And when you mix them together, they stick everything together and you end up with this slime, and then it sort of goes drier and it looks more like a sort of rubber, actually. Does it bounce well? Mm. Oh, really? Is that it? Well, that's not a bad demo, but let's see what happens as Katie looks after that over a bit longer. Right. So that's our first polymerization reaction. Now, what else have we got then? We've got. What I really want is something a bit slimier. This is made of sort of actually quite a dry rubber.
That sounds like my apartment, Mark.
Okay, Phil, off you go then. Let's see what you can do.
Let's see what I can do. Great. I think I can do one better. In fact, I am definitely sure that I can do one better.
Can we have a volunteer to help out?
Of course.
All right, can we have a volunteer? Oh, let's go. Can we have you there on the end? There we go. Thank you very much. Right.
What's your name?
Ollie.
Come around here, Ollie. Right, Ollie, so you have been helping with this. We're going to be making something called jelly worms. Who likes jelly worms? Yeah, we all, once again with the hand. All right then, Ollie, so what we're going to be doing is we're going to be mixing two really slimy things together. So first off, let's start with this. So, in fact, do you want to put a glove on? There you go, you can have a glove. So So, in here I've got a very special chemical. It's called sodium alginate. Has anyone heard of that before? Yeah, you've heard of it before, really? No? No, okay. Well, sodium alginate, actually, it comes from seaweed.
Really? Is that what makes seaweed slimy then?
Exactly.
Why is the sand wet?
Because the seaweed...
Thank you.
Give him a round of applause for that,
Luke. No, please. A
sarcastic one.
Yeah, there we go.
Okay, we've got this thing. So we went to the beach and we got all our seaweed and we made this stuff. So can you see this stuff? Oh, it's really nice and thick and slimy. Can you see that, everyone? Oh, gross.
And so sodium alginate, is that already a polymer, is it?
Yeah, so that's already these very long
molecules.
These very long molecules. And what we're going to do now, we're actually going to bind those long molecules together to make something slimy. And you can help me with that, because I've got some in this bottle. And as you can already see, I coloured it green, because that's my favourite slimy colour. What's your favourite slimy colour?
Green!
Fantastic, right. And simply what we're going to do in here, we've got a bowl of calcium. What's calcium good for? Oh, fantastic. All I want you to do, is pour this stuff into there. You do that? Fantastic, there you go. So you grab the bottle and you just squeeze it in. Really fast, keep squeezing, like that, there we go.
Brilliant.
Right, brilliant. Let's just give that a bit of a shake. Now, with your glove, what I want you to do is... Ooh, that's not a glove. That's a glove. I want you to pull them out. Yep, put your hand and pull them out.
Thank you. Turn it around and show everybody.
So there's a bit there, so you hold that bit with me. Let's go around and show everyone. Oh.
It's like a very big old baby.
Can you
see
that? Oh, wow. Amazing, isn't it? Oh, I'm going to get all over you now. You don't need this green bottom. Let's go over here. We haven't shown these guys.
I'll show these guys.
Oh, you want to show them?
Oh, my God. It just
pulled. Fantastic, Ollie. Give a round of applause for Ollie, everyone. So what we've done here is, as I said, we have that very, very long chain of sodium alginate. We bind them together using calcium. And we've got this, what we call cross-linking. And this cross-linking makes these lovely gooey worms, whoopsie-daisies, that you can see here. Whoa, they're getting everywhere. Back.
Oh, brilliant. Oh, Katie, it's your bouncy ball, by the way. Remember that stuff Katie made earlier? It's actually turned to a bouncy ball as well. Right, anyway.
Not quite as good as jelly worms.
No, the jelly worms are good. Right. And that's actually pretty much, that thing that Phil showed you there, is pretty much how some of those jelly sweets are made. Yeah? Sodium alginate, the mix, and calcium. And the calcium links all those long chains together. And of course, in sweets, you've got a lot more sugar and things in there as well. I wouldn't eat these. They taste horrible as it is. Excellent. So we've seen a couple of good polymer reactions and things. And these are nice, I mean, but I'm not sure I'd still call them slime, would you?
Yeah.
No, I mean, they're wormy, but they're not really slimy. But what we have seen already is that we can make, with different chemicals, different things with very different properties. So we've got the jelly worms and we've got the sort of rubbery stuff. But what I want, really, is a top-notch, gooey, disgusting slime. Right, okay. And so, I think it's time for a head-to-head challenge between Phil and Katie to see who can make me the best, should we say, bouncy slime?
Do you guys like bouncy slime?
Yeah!
Yeah! Alright, let's make some bouncy slime then. Alright. Oh, we're just getting some more things. I think we're going to use some volunteers for this as well, aren't we, Mark? Oh, who hasn't been up yet? Who hasn't been up yet? Oh. You can use that set next to you. And you because you're stood up on the chair. So you're really eager. Yep, you there. And fantastic. We've got 4 volunteers. So that's worked out quite nicely, boy v girls. Messy table. This is where I pull all my messy stuff.
So what's this slime based on then, guys? Phil? What's this slime based on?
So this slime, so what do we need for slime? Once again, we need those long, long chains, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah. And then we need to cross link them together, don't we?
Yeah.
So what we're going to be doing is using some polyvinyl acetate. Has anyone heard of that before? It's known in the corridors as PVA glue. Have you all heard of it now?
Yeah!
Fantastic, that's what the PVA stands for. And then we're going to be using something called borax. So borax is a chemical, and that chemical is going to bind the PVA glue together, and then that's how we make the slime. Oh, and we've also got some water, because of course we want really slimy slime. So the more watery it is, the better it is. Don't worry, I've got my own bottle of Kate, don't worry. Oh, she spoke. Okay, so I've got some gloves for you guys. There's one, there's another. Keep going. Yeah, I'm going to put one on as well. You've got to put them on like a proper surgeon, and proper surgeons do this. You've got your gloves on, so you're going to be my stirrer. And you're going to stir that around. Oh, you're making such a mess, Kevin. Here we go. Okay. And what do we need after we've made this this solution of borax and water? We need the glue. Yes, we need the glue. You can be my glue dispenser. So what I want you to do is, do you have a teddy bear? Yeah, I want you to hug it like a teddy bear, okay? Here we go. I'll help, don't worry. You're blocking up the audience. Ah! You missed? Okay, that's enough. I think that's more than enough. And, I like blue. Who likes blue?
Me!
Let's put some blue in there. There goes the blue.
How are we doing?
Okay, can the guys on that? I'm stopping a bit. Can the guys on that stop mixing that
together? We've got a very clean, precise method here. And
Katie's gonna bounce at the highest!
Come on, goes running. So this is just exactly, it's just corn flour
and water.
So you've come across all this before, haven't you?
Yeah.
And it is called a non-Newtonian liquid. Okay, you all got that? We'll be testing on it later. It's a non-Newtonian liquid, which basically means that it sometimes acts like a liquid, but sometimes acts like a solid. And it's pretty gooey and yucky. Now the thing is, as cool as this is, and most of you played with this sort of stuff before?
Yeah!
I'm just going to rinse my hands quickly. We've got a, there's actually a much more interesting use for non-Newtonian liquids. And this is an example of one of them. This is made by a company called D3O, and they make this putty. Yeah? And it's, see this? Now this stuff is awesome, because it looks like a putty, yeah? And you can stretch it like a putty. See that? Yeah? If you stretch it slowly, it stretches really nicely. But if you stretch it quickly, it snaps. Yeah? And same thing, if you hit it, push it slowly, I can stick my finger through it. But if I hit it harder, oh, it's a bit thick there. You think of it. I just can't. Yeah? And this stuff, just like that, where it goes hard when you put it under pressure, this stuff goes hard under pressure as well. And this stuff is so useful, so it gets so hard when you put a lot of pressure on it, that it's actually used in bulletproof vests. They put this in the chest and the chest plates of soldiers, and then some of the bullets will bounce off it. So it's really and really useful stuff. Now then, I thought we'd do a demo of that. Okay. Can we borrow the just to see how sure we are that this is actually going to work. Can I borrow the mallet? Oh, that's a mallet. Right then. So let me just show you again. We can squish it. Yeah. But if I hit it, it doesn't compress. So. Make a column of it. There. Squish it. Right, now Phil is kindly volunteered to demonstrate just how good this stuff is. He's going to let me hit his hand with a mallet. Right, go then, Phil. Ready?
Harder?
Over the
hand!
Harder!
Over the hand!
How was that?
Hey.
How was that? And this stuff, like I said, it's a practical, real use of slime. Okay? Now, this stuff is actually really, really expensive. Most of these slimes we've all made with corn flour, and glue, and things like that that you can find at home or in the supermarket. This stuff is actually made by a company, and this goo here is worth about £400. So £400 worth of goo because it's so, so special. In fact,
what we're basically trying to say is, don't try this at home.
Okay.
Results may vary a little bit.
So this is a particular, very, very special slime, yeah? £400 worth. It took a lot of research to figure it out, to get it just right so it's light and has exactly the right properties, yeah? And, in fact, they're so secretive about what this is, they won't tell me what it is, isn't it? Yeah? I asked them, I said, well, that's really great, I'd love to explain how it works to a load of people. And they went, no, can't tell you. So it's a complete secret, yeah, about how this lovely stuff works. Right, what's up next then?
Well, I think we've seen how slime has been made, haven't we? You don't sound too sure.
Yes!
Okay, and we've had a look at some of its uses, haven't we?
Yes!
So where can we use slime for?
Yes!
That wasn't a yes or no answer, but thank you. So where can we use it for?
Bulletproof
vests. Yes, fantastic, bulletproof vests. But there is another use, because so far, one thing, yeah?
You can use it for gravy.
You can use it, you know, that's for gravy.
Yeah, thickening gravy. Yeah.
They also use it in dancer shoes. So, my bad. But so far, and agree with me here if you want, we've only looked at it man-made, haven't we? Everything we've looked at has been man-made, yeah? No?
Yeah!
So what about natural slime? Because we find it in nature, don't we?
Yeah.
Yeah? Where do we find it in nature? Oh, we've got a hand up at the back.
Up your nose.
Fantastic. Thank you. Gross. Well, that's good. Do you have one? Yeah? In your throat. Fantastic. Whoops. There's a quick left. Yeah? Up somebody's nose again. So mainly up each other's nose. What about this one here? So this, right here, this is my good friend, Sheldon. And over here we have Michelle.
Get it?
Yeah. And these are very, very special. These are actually not garden snails. These are giant African land snails. They don't look that big because these are actually babies. They actually grow to be about this big. So, where do snails use slime? It's on their foot. Yes, exactly. They use it on their feet. Where else do you think they use it? Inside their shell, you're very close. What about over here? I'm sort of picking on this group over here. What are you? Where is the slime? To protect the body, fantastic. Those are two great suggestions. In fact, those are the two kinds of slime that snails have. They have it on their feet. What do you think that helped them to do? Move them around a lot quicker, yes. Even though it's still really slow, imagine how slow it would be if they didn't have any slime on their feet at all. What about the second one that covers their body? What do you think that's for? Huh? Yes, so it's to keep them from going wet. Is there any way we can show this, do you think, Mark? I don't think they've quite got it. I know they've got the fact that they use it to move, but I don't think they've got any... Do you guys know exactly what we're talking about?
No.
I think we need somebody to demonstrate how a slime helps a snail move, don't you, Phil?
Yeah, that'd be great. We've got quite a few hands up.
No, I don't think this is one for them, Phil. I think you might have to take the mantle here, Phil.
Do what?
Well, try and move like a snail.
How do snails move?
And slugs.
They stick their bums in the air, yes.
Slime! Oh, slime!
Oh. 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 Oh.
used for? What else is used for? That's the transport. What was the other things that you said slime sometimes used for? Yeah?
Moisture.
Moisture, fantastic.
Yeah, and also protection, wasn't it? Yeah? It protects you. It can protect, sometimes protect you from being invaded by bugs and and viruses and bacteria. So what we need, again, is another demonstration of that sort of thing.
Here we go.
So,
have I got specs? I do have specs somewhere. So it's made out of what these very, very long molecules, and they've got a very special name. They start with P, and it's not Phil. Not Philippa either. Polymers, fantastic. Yes, you all remember polymers? Yes, so that is what slime's made out of. Then what did we do?
The polymers, yeah? And then we have to get to make a real slime, we've got to do something to our polymers. Yeah. Go on, Phil. Have you got somebody over there who wants to try and answer?
Yes. So you've got these long chains. Oh, you don't have to come down. It's fine. It's fine. You can sit down. We're just asking questions. Don't worry. So you've got these very long chains. What do we have to do to make them slimy? We have to join them together somehow. It's a special word beginning with C. Not calcium, but calcium did it. Calcium did it. Well done. You were for me, weren't you? You're the one that made the mess. They're very cross, these things. Very, very cross.
Cross.
Does that help?
They're cross-links. Do you remember? Yeah. You've got long chains, and the long chains look sort of gooey, runny, thick liquid. But when you cross-link them together, you make a slime or all those bunchicles that Katie made. So we need things to cross-link the polymers. Now, what do we use, do you remember, to cross-link some of those polymers? Anybody remember?
Well, we got one over here, didn't we? What did we use? Calcium.
Calcium. That's right. So the calcium stuck to two of the polymers, the long chains, and stuck them together and made a sort of gel, big gel-like thing that made it was much more slimy.
Yes.
Right. And what else did we use to make slime?
Glue.
And the glue, again, long, thin polymer molecules cross-linked with borax in it. And then we looked at some of the uses for slimes, like, for example, what sort of uses for slimes were there? And putties and things. Yeah. Bulletproof vest, so the D3O stuff that was called. That was called do you remember what type of thing it was called? It was called a non-Newtonian liquid. Tricky one, that. And they're slimes that go hard when you put them under pressure. Right? So corn flour and water does that. But you won't want to put corn flour and water in a bulletproof vest. Instead, loads of really clever scientists have worked out a really great light material that you can put in bulletproof vests. Right? And did you say it's in dancers' shoes as well?
Yes, they use it. Do we have any dancers in the house? Yes, do we have any ballerinas in the house? I really wanted to be a ballerina, but I didn't have the feet. Thank you for that. Yes, so it's actually used. They put it in ballerina's shoes, so that when you put your shoes on, they mould around your feet, and when you start dancing, it goes really solid. Now who's the ballerina?
Yeah. And then we talked about natural uses of slimes. That we've got snot and slimes that help snails move, behave. Slimes that help snails and slugs move and things like that. So we are now, I think, approaching the point of our show where you guys have to decide who